These two are the biggest. All right, welcome back to another episode of Making Magic Fishing. What's up, all you magic makers? Cheers. I hope you guys are having an amazing freaking day. Or I hope you guys are having a good day. I hope everyone's out there staying safe, loving each other, keeping the love going and flowing. And today, as you can see by the title or the thumbnail, this is part number two to the video where I freaking whacked them. I never get that lucky and get six keeper size reds. A couple that were actually, I was super excited. That was one of those magical days. Doesn't come around too often where you just get that many reds. I don't know why, but I don't know if they're fished out, if they're just, I don't know. I got really lucky. Anyways, this is the cook part. I got some water boiling. Making Magic Cooking's going down. I'm about to get some stuff prepped. Come along with us. Ow. All right, you guys, so back out here. We got the barbecue going on the charcoal grill. Well, it's not the charcoal grill. It's actually the oak wood grill. We got the usual suspects, the secret ingredients. We got the fish. Now, this is fish from 2 days ago. It's been resting. We let it rest. This bag holds all fillets of the red rock cod. I don't know if they're exactly called red snapper, but they're red rock cod, rock fish. Locally, California, Central California, in between LA and the Bay. We're about how many hours from the Bay? I used to do the drive with my uncle. I think it's about 5 hours from San Francisco, and we're about three and a half hours from LA. About two and 45 minutes or so, give or take. We got the tomatoes right here. We got onion, we got purple cabbage. We got the tortillas. They're gonna be warmed up on the grill. We got corn going. We got some butter going in the pan. So stay tuned. Talk to you guys in a minute here. Oh wait, I'll open it now. Opening it, peeling it, because that looks good. Uncle Billy likes this part, and then he likes to see the butter go in the pan, and he likes to see the butter melt. Mm-hmm. I promise you, I wouldn't lie to you. All right, Uncle Billy, here's the butter. Fisherman's lifestyle.
Camping style.
Papow style. All right.
Dad.
All right, there it is. Stay tuned. All right, so here we are. We are grilling over the oak wood. We got these guys going. I'm gonna go ahead and put some tortillas on. Go and start warming up. Start warming up our tortillas here. Because we're about to have quite a few fish all at once. I'm just gonna go ahead and whack some tacos here, Mexican style. And I'm gonna go ahead and get something to flip those. You gotta have one of these when you're barbecuing like this. And if you don't keep an eye on your tortillas, they will burn. I gotta flip these fish. It's already been about, I don't know, 2 minutes. I can hardly see because the smoke is whacking me. Looks like this stuff is turning out pretty good. About, I just flipped them all, so I'm saying another minute or two on that side. A couple minutes, they should be done. We got tortillas. My dad cut some lemon. I got the avocado cut. We got the toppings. And stay tuned, you guys are not gonna wanna miss this one. Not quite. These smaller pieces gotta be done.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Might need to do a couple more tortillas. Those ones might have burned, I don't know. Throw a couple on just for a second. They only need to be on that second. Ouch. All right. I gotta get this thing. All right.
But that we use that for the fish, so don't use that one. I use those two for the fish. Well, I'm just saying it's raw fish on there, which ain't bad, but.
Can you make here. Yourself a couple tacos real quick? Like?
I know, I'm trying to.
They're making it good.
All right.
Rip. You don't need more than a... No, that's enough
piece,
fish.
Huh? One piece, chunk?
That's enough, yeah.
All right, so we got the fish. And we got... some lemon going down. Oh, my God. We got the avocado in there. We got lemon going on. We got tomatoes, a little tomato. Ooh, doesn't that look good? All right, now let me grab some that purple stuff. Okay. Some of this onion, purple onion. More. Now those are gonna be good. We got my dad's going down. And I'm just gonna go ahead and take a bite of this and tell you guys how I like it, how it came out.
Let me be the judge.
Cheers. Now. Oh my God. The combination of the avocado, tomatoes, cabbage, the fresh fish, the tortilla barbecued on the grill. I don't think it could get any better than that. That was dang near the closest, best fish that I've ever had. You gonna have a bite? You gonna try a little bite of this fish? Here we go. Fresh butter, cast iron, barbecue, ocean fish, rock cod, pow. That is some amazing stuff, right? Was that good?
We had the fire.
Did you taste it? Was that good? Oh, Grandma got the fire. Got the corn going on fire. This is burning down the whole cornfield.
What the normal for a second.
Oh my God. Bite number two. It gets even better. Here.
I was just putting lures on.
Are you putting lures?
I was putting weights on hooks.
How is it? Is it good? What do you think? Really good?
Mm-hmm. I hope Mike can see
that one. Oh, man. All right. So... we're gonna go ahead and finish, you know, making a couple more tacos. We got plenty of meat left. Cody's getting down on grubbing some. Dad, how are they?
Good.
Pretty dang good. Pretty good idea.
Yep.
Well, sounds like, and cheers. We'll see you guys in a little bit.
Living your life.
And, yeah. This was an amazing dinner. I was blessed on going out and catching these fish, I never get this lucky and catch five or I think I got six reds. The limit is 10 fish, and I believe I got six of them to be red rock cod, the more desirable, better tasting species. They're harder to get, come by. I don't know why. The farther out I go, the better I find them, the bigger I find them. If I stay close to shore, I have a hard time finding them, and I have a hard time finding bigger ones. So I'm gonna continue to make the trek as far out as I can on the days that have the best conditions that allow me to get out there. I'm really excited about the spot that I've been finding them at. I believe I have landmarks that I look one way and I'm able to look at and kind of like judge where I'm at. I have another second landmark, and it's been prevailing. I got really lucky this last time. Stay tuned. I'll talk to you guys in a minute. You bet.
How's the baby?
Oh yeah. There's that good shot. Fresh cod on the barbecue and stuff. You might be asking how I'm doing. Well, we got a boneless fillet. Shout out to you, Prof. We got a boneless fillet. A boneless fillet.
What do we do when it's done?
Oh man. So good.
How do we pause it?